In February, when it's still frigid at night but daytime temperatures are warming, it may look like trees are just sitting there doing nothing. But inside their cells, spring has already begun. Buds are fattening and changing color, and sap is starting to flow. Each late winter day, gallons move from the roots to the branch tips. Now is the time to tap sugar maples. The sweet sap is sort of like a tree's blood because it carries nutrients to feed the developing leaves and flowers. But it also serves another critical function. The concentrated sugars pull extra water into the plant's vascular system by osmosis. That increases the pressure inside and gets rid of air bubble blockages that have formed over the winter. Yellow-bellied sapsuckers figured out how to tap trees long before humans did. Their drilling leaves a distinctive row of holes. Red squirrels are maple tappers too, gnawing through the bark to create small wounds that drip sap. After the sap evaporates, the squirrels return to lick the concentrated sugars. Black-capped chickadees keep an eye on the squirrels' work and fly in to steal some of the sweet sap, and so do moths. Sugar maples solved their problem of repairing air bubbles, and then birds, squirrels, insects, and humans learned to exploit it.